You have so come to the right place if you want more of that Extra Factor action. We've got more laughter. We've got more tears. And we've got more gossip. And welcome to the Extra Factor! Welcome to The Extra Factor. I'm Holly Willoughby, and look at these guys behind me. They're literally raring to go. Although, between you and me, they're probably all suffering from the same sore throat and the latest death of their family pet. But hopefully, they're not worried about their choice of song, because I'm sure they've all chosen the right song, right?
Right.
Let's hope they have, because we're back in Birmingham and ready for another day filled with sweet music. All we need now are some judges, and with Danny down under, who might this be?
Lou!
Am I first here again?
How are you? I'm making an arch. Welcome to Birmingham.
You look great.
Thanks, how are you? You all right?
What happened? You look great.
What do you mean, have I not looked great up until now?
Well, you look good, but today you look really great.
Looking out for me.
You look like somebody out of Girls Aloud.
Do I?
Yeah.
Thanks, I'll take that as a huge compliment.
Louie!
I'm looking for somebody new.
Okay.
You, young, nice to work with. Like you.
Thanks.
Honestly, if you could sing, you'd be great.
All by myself anymore. But I can't. And the other judges, are they looking forward to Birmingham?
There's no other judge. I'm the main judge. I'm the professional judge, Harry. You know that.
You got in for a little treat today.
I'm in for a treat.
Yes.
Can I get exact again?
No. I'll catch up with you later and tell you all about it.
Do.
All right?
Do.
It's very special.
Okay, see you, Holly.
And next to arrive... Have you performed in Birmingham before?
Yes, we just performed actually a few weeks ago at the NIE and then at the NEC.
And what are you expecting from today? Have you got any...
I'm hoping to find some nice boy bands.
You think the Midlands can provide the boys?
I hope so.
Forget about the boy, Cheryl. Here's the man himself. Good morning. Why are you... Oh, no, don't start, Simon. What's wrong?
It's like a cake or something, I don't know.
What I'm wearing is a cake. That's a terrible way to start the day. Cake? Huh. Fine, whatever. Two can play at that game. Here's some shots of you pulling some really silly faces. Better move on to our first contestant.
My name's Paul. I'm from Birmingham. I'm 53.
So, Paul, big day today.
Yes, well, my ultimate dream is to make records and one day to conquer America.
Who would you compare yourself to?
I like powerful, strong singers. So if I could be a male, Celine Dion.
Absolutely. She's got a belting voice. Mm-hmm. Is your voice powerful?
It can be.
How powerful?
Powerful enough.
Okay, sir, just stand on the X, please. What's your name?
Paul.
And why are you here today?
Well, it's in my blood, entertaining, singing. I just need to do it.
Off you go.
Okay. Without love, I've nothing. Without love, I have nothing. Was a bit rough.
Paul, Simon?
Paul, I mean, basically, you didn't sing, you just screamed like you were shouting at us, or you felt like you were telling us off.
You shame.
Yeah, it was like being in the middle of a hurricane.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, Louis, yes or no?
No. Cheryl?
I would say go to the pubs and stuff. You could make a good pub entertainer.
He'd certainly clear the pub.
Cheryl?
No.
All right, but nice to meet you both.
Well, I'm thinking it would only be fair if we tested the power of your voice. I'm going to pop on a pair of ear defenders. Can you hear? That's how powerful they are, OK? Right, I'm all in. Paul, in your own time, take it away. I'm glad I had these on. And for those of you in Birmingham who can still hear, listen up for some sound advice.
Don't do that, don't do that, don't do that. Don't do that, don't do that, don't do that.
When it comes to auditions,
yeah.
What are your top five do's and don'ts?
Come in with confidence.
Hello. That was a very confident walk.
Smile, you must smile.
Yes.
You've got the best smile I've ever seen in my life. Thank you. I mean, seriously.
Thank you.
You must know your limits with your songs. So don't sing Whitney.
Where do broken hearts go?
Or Mariah.
And the sorrow that you know will melt away.
I'm going to stop you there. You must sell yourself, because when you walk in that door to us, we kind of make up our mind, yes or no.
Do you think you can win the X Factor?
Roughly, yeah.
Wear clothes that suit you. Don't show too much, you know.
Got a great set of teeth.
Not good.
Well, it depends on the bod underneath, you know.
But so it's all right if you've
yeah,
got
yeah, if you've got the bod underneath, it's okay.
Good bods, you say, Louis? What an uncannily fortuitous, convenient link to our next auditionee. What are the chances?
My name is Zara Palmer, and I'm a student.
Hey! Somebody give us some water in here!
Let's talk about what you're wearing. Very okay. Stylish, very beachwear.
Yeah, but it's a hot day.
Hot, you say? Looks a little chilly in here to me. I think Simon might be quite impressed.
Hopefully. But I'm hoping he's more impressed by my voice. So I might be a little early.
She's sexy!
Hi.
Hi. And what's your name?
My name's Zara.
Best body we've had in here. Look at that.
Thank you.
Why are you here?
Well, I've got the look, I've got the body, I've got the voice. I think I've got the full package.
And how old are you, Zara?
28 years young.
God, you look younger.
Yeah.
All right, Zara, and off you go.
Didn't I make you feel like you were the only man? Oh, didn't I give you almost everything that a woman possibly can? Yes, you did. Each time I tell myself that I think I've had too much, but I'm gonna show you, baby, that a woman can be tough. Take another little bit of my heart now, darling.
Okay.
I like you. I think your nerves took over a bit. You were losing it a bit at the top end of the song. But I think you've got a lovely tone of voice and I like your look. I think you're really pretty.
Oh, thank you.
Zara, I think you've got a great voice in there somewhere. I think you need a lot of work.
Okay.
You look terrific, got a good attitude. And you've got a powerful voice in there. Louis, what? Yes or no?
Yes.
Oh, thank you very much.
Cheryl?
Yes.
Oh, thank
Zara,
you.
Zara, 100% yes. I think you've got real potential.
Thanks very much. Pleasure to meet you all.
Likewise.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
One of the best bodies I've ever seen in my life. I mean, seriously.
Sometimes I think it's sexier though if you don't
it show it.
Yeah, Cheryl's got a point.
So Zara's off to boot camp, leaving a lasting impression on the ever professional Dermot O'Leary. Behave, Dermy! So, what sort of impression had she left on our judges?
Thanks, Tony.
I wanted to ask you about Zara. Gorgeous Zara, very beautiful body, but YouTube thing.
It's not very good. Change the subject. Not very good weather today, is it?
Simon fancy.
Is this what you are on about?
Simon definitely fancied her.
What Simon. I said was,
so
I think
it should,
sometimes
clear up.
tomorrow the
weather. Why are you doing this?
What was they doing?
They're trying to create some sort of animosity.
How was the lunch, Lou?
You fancy.
So what I said was basically...
You said she needed to maybe put some more clothes on.
Yeah, but not because she didn't have a gorgeous body. It was clear for everybody to see that she did. Yeah. I don't know if Simon knows what her face looked like. Did you see her face?
Yeah.
From here up?
No, I just think it's a bit...
She did.
From which view?
Yeah.
Maybe I should have sat where you were sitting. Yeah. I just think it's a bit more sexy and a bit
to soften
more,
it up.
Yeah.
Less is
not
more.
That she didn't have it to show off. Totally.
Yeah.
She totally did.
What are you doing?
Claws.
Still to come.
I've got an enormous.
I'm trying to help.
You're corrupting our talent.
Flapjacks.
Right, who's next? Oh, it's you. Welcome back. Let's see who is our next auditionee. You need one of those. Straight up the stairs. With a record turnout this year, the competition is tougher than ever. But our next auditionee is confident he has got everything our judges are looking for. And more.
My name is Andrew Parity. I'm 23 and I'm from Crawley, West Sussex. Singing is my life really, it's just my one dream in life. I would like to be quite famous, win awards, number one US, UK and album. I feel I have what it takes to win the X Factor. I've got the talent, look quite presentable. I'm quite kind, down to earth, gentleman, quite hygienic, I always wash, got a lot of charisma, I love cooking, I'm one of a kind, Andrew Parity, there's no one else like me.
Hello.
How are you? Good. And what's your name, please?
My name's Andrew Parity.
Okay, Andrew, which artist do you think you could be as popular as? Which thing?
Bryan Adams.
And?
Bon Jovi.
Yeah. Anyone else?
Leona.
Leona. Okay. What's the song?
Bryan Adams' Heaven.
Heaven. Okay. Off you go, Andrew.
Oh, thinking about our younger years, there was only you and me. We were young and wild and free. Now nothing to take you away from me. Ain't down that road before. That's over now. Keep me running back for more. Baby, you're all I want. When you're lying here in my arms, finding hard to believe we're in heaven.
All right, thank you very much.
Well, I'm not in heaven. That was horrendous.
Bit rude.
Horrendous.
Do this weird twitchy thing when you sing. It was putting me off.
Louis, yes or no?
No. Horrendous.
Cheryl?
No.
Danny?
No.
Fine, thanks, Andrew. It's a no.
You're lying here in my arms.
I'm finding it hard to believe we're in heaven.
I can't understand why the judges said no. I gave it 120% and this was guarantee my best performance.
Horrendous.
Louis said I was disgraceful.
That was horrendous.
I didn't have a chance, really.
Horrendous.
I'm giving up. Giving up altogether.
But I hard believe.
Thanks to Louis, I'm giving up. My one biggest dream in my life.
Well, I'm not in heaven. That was horrendous.
But he's taken my heart and just thrown it on the floor, basically, Louis. Yeah. He's horrible.
Horrendous. Horrendous, 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 horrendous.
We on The Extra Factor pride ourselves on the powers of backstage investigation, tackling the most sensitive and taboo of issues, and we have just sniffed out a real corker.
You can't underestimate how important your sense of smell is when you do The X Factor.
Right, can I just say something?
You're absolutely
right. Okay, so what you don't realise is there's like the holding room area. And then there's the area of the corridor where Dermot is. And they all sit on those seats, right?
Yeah.
Right, Dermot's area
And I'm hoping it's not because Dermot's in it.
It really
smells
stinks.
Really,
what
really
does it smell
bad.
Because like? I can't.
It smells like someone's had a poo in the corner.
Booyah! The problem is, where we are is a very nervous place. And we've got lights everywhere, so it's quite a hot place.
Yeah.
And hot plus nerves equals flatulence.
I've had an idea, because you know when you're on aeroplanes and they pack aeroplane seats with carbon, and so when people fart on planes, it doesn't smell.
Is that why?
This is a fact. Not many people know this. So I'm thinking that row of seats, they need to have carbon covers.
Yeah, because it is. It absolutely honks down there.
Oh,
and
no.
I swear to God, it's not me.
Auditions are in full swing. And out of the thousands that have turned up, this guy's managed to meet no one.
My name's Greg Bradley. I'm a plumber.
Oh, the plumber!
When I'm at work, I drive my workmates nuts because I'm always singing all the time.
And not be leaking my drain.
Since a little kid, I've always been singing. It's always been my dream. That's always what I've wanted to do.
Call the plumber.
What makes me different is I've got the ambition, I've got the drive, and people have told me I've kind of got the little boy band look, maybe.
Hi.
And I think I've got a great voice.
How are you?
I'm not too bad, thank you. Yeah.
I'm a plumber with a pipe dream.
What's your name?
Greg Bradley.
What are you going to sing, Greg?
I know it sounds really stupid, but I'm not quite sure. I can kind of sing classically, and I can sing rock as well.
I can't imagine you singing rock music.
I can try for you.
Wake up, Maggie, I think I got something to say to you.
Right, stop. That is not you.
No?
No.
You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas.
Okay.
I think you got a good classical voice. I didn't like the rock bit at all.
Okay.
I mean, you actually can sing. Your problem is that, number one, you don't know who you are, which is a huge mistake. Secondly, you've got a look on your face that tells me you've sort of been beaten.
Beaten.
You know, you have no confidence, no charisma, absolutely none whatsoever.
Right.
And that is a real, real problem because it makes you nervous when you listen to you. You've got to reinvent yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what you're wearing is horrendous, hair's terrible.
What do you suggest?
I want to see if it's possible for you to come back as a different person.
Right.
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah, come back tomorrow.
Okay.
Have you got any suggestions? No.
Just you asking me the question now means that this message is not getting through.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm saying to you is come back arrogant, horrible, unrecognisable, but good.
So come back as Simon.
Good job.
Thank you for your time, okay?
Cause I need a man. Right, you'd better go and find some charisma then, Greg.
What is charisma?
Not a great start. So while Greg asks just about anyone what charisma is, I have got a life or death situation of my own to sort out. Presentiators. Yeah, probably the most important thing I've ever done in my life.
Yeah.
At the moment, I have got Louis and Simon as my presentiator mentors and Cheryl's with Dermot. So I'm thinking if I get three, he's only got one and that would be amazing.
Dermot needs some help though, really.
I can't compete, you're a heavyweight.
This is true.
Plus he has very lovely arms. Supernatural. He does.
But
I have to give him a bit of support.
Supernatural. You may have won Danny over with your lovely arms, but beware, O'Leary, ultimate victory will be mine. Wah!
Present me. My heart will go on and on.
on then, kick my ass, and I'll get out of here.
That's the power of the Willoughby lungs, Dermot. I'm way ahead of you now. The sun is rising in London. For most people, it is the dawn of an all-new day. But for one, it is the dawn of an all-new man. Greg was given a second chance.
Come back, arrogant, horrible, unrecognizable, but good.
Now he's back. And he intends to deliver.
Do you feel more cocky? Are you kind of like, right,
I'll try to be. I'll do my best for him. He said be arrogant.
Yeah.
I'm not really an arrogant person.
Well, I've been having a little think overnight as well, which I'm sure you have, and I think I've got a few tips that might be able to
help.
Right,
okay.
Just a few little, like, subconscious thoughts that can go through your mind, and then on the outside, it will project...
Right.
Arrogance.
Okay.
Okay, so let's just try a few of them.
Yeah.
I've got an enormous bank balance.
Right.
Try it.
I've got enormous bank balance.
An enormous. Do it again. Do it better than that.
I've got an enormous bank balance.
Do you believe him?
No, I didn't believe him.
No. I drive a Porsche.
I drive a Porsche.
Nice! I've got great hair.
I've got great hair.
Good. I've got size 12 feet.
I've got size 12 feet.
Know what I mean?
Yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you. Hey there.
Hi.
Back
you
again.
Found your
suited
suit.
And booted. Hope you like it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good for you.
So, yeah.
And how do you feel today?
More confident.
Almost overconfident.
But I just can't wait to sing for you.
Wow.
Though the old hometown...
Stop. Prepare yourself.
Okay. I've got an enormous...
The tyre's a bit distracting.
Don't like it.
No. Sorry. Much better.
Okay.
Much better. Yeah. Okay.
I've got size 12 feet. The old hometown looks the same as I step down from the train. And there to meet me is my mama and my papa. Down the road I look, and there runs Mary. Hair of gold and lips like cherries, it's good to touch the green grass of home.
Wow, what a transformation.
Thank you.
I mean, this could be literally a show where I ask people to transform.
And I did my best for you.
I hate to sound egotistical about this, but I feel like I've changed your life.
Yeah, I think you have. I really do. And I feel so much more confident in myself.
I can see that.
Okay, we're going to vote. Simon, yes or no?
You raise me up so I can stand on mountains.
No.
I'm going to say no. It's still not good enough.
I was going to say yes. I would thoroughly enjoy watching you in a musical or in a theatre show, but I don't think for The X Factor, so I'm going to say no.
As a West End audition, it was terrific. As a recording artist, no. But I'm kind of glad that we went through this process because I've seen a different you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anyway.
Keep the confidence up,
Greg.
Thank you.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, well, it wasn't bad comments, was it?
So. No, and do you know what? A massive improvement on yesterday.
Yeah, I was more confident. I, you know, wore a suit for them and everything.
Did you think of the things I was telling you to think of?
Yeah, I was confident. It's just not what they're looking for, I suppose. I'm more musical theatre.
Someone who did have a second chance today was Greg. You sent him away yesterday and you were like, right, go away.
He wasn't good enough.
No, but I've made him into a more confident human being. So it's like I was working miracles in that room.
I actually had a bit of a chat with him beforehand.
Oh, so you're taking responsibility for this.
Yeah, we had a bit of a technique.
Should he listen to you more?
In his head, and I don't know whether you saw this, he had sentences that he was saying in his head over and over. One was, I drive a Porsche. And the second was, I've got size 12 feet. That's what he was thinking. And I think
that
this is the key.
You've made him think that he's got a big...
Has he?
But you thought that he was more confident.
That's what put us off.
Yeah.
He was overconfident.
Don't say that, have I ruined this?
He kept looking down. And okay. Why do you get a smile on his face today?
I'm trying to help.
No, you're corrupting our talent.
Don't blame me.
Yeah, right.
Delta come.
Whoa! 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 Do you know how much that meant to us?
No, it's a stupid song.
Hello and welcome to The Extra Factor. We're here in Manchester, although I think I might have got here a little bit early. Where on earth is everyone? Feels like some kind of... Ah, there they are. Raring to go. Better get started then. Now, before any auditions begin, there is only one man that the contestants are waiting for. He's been in the industry since before I was born. When he walks into a room,
yeah,
he has that presence. He's almost got the X Factor himself.
That's right, viewers. It's Louis Simon.
Why is it always about you?
It's not.
It's always about you.
It's not.
This year, it's all about Simon. From the world's
greatest. I imagine this is having an effect on his already
quite large ego. I love
myself. Yes, Simon, we know. And here's yet another member of the Mr. Cow fan club.
My name's Michelle, I'm 20 and I'm from Doncaster.
Hi, Michelle.
Hiya.
How are you feeling today?
I'm a bit nervous, but excited, because I've always wanted to meet Simon Cowell. When I grow up, I want to be famous, I want to be a star, I want to be a movie. My ultimate dream is to just perform in front of thousands of people, see all these celebrities and go to parties and just everything.
So how much singing have you done in the past?
None really, a little bit. Well, yeah, a bit. I don't know. I went to ballet school, you see. But when I walk in that room, I'm going to sock it to Simon Cowell, and he is going to love it.
Whoa!
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 God, your legs go on forever, don't they?
Ever. I know, and I can do the trick.
Wow!
So that's a yes from Simon.
Wowza.
I'm a ballerina, you see. Yeah.
That's a yes from the boys, then.
Can't believe I'm seeing Simon.
Do you know Simon?
Who doesn't? Do you know what I mean?
What about Louis?
Yeah, my mum loves Louis. She's like, can we go on a double date? Can Simon take me and you take my mum?
I'd consider that.
Yeah. Oh.
Is your mum here?
Yeah, she's here.
Well, let's bring her in the room.
Now?
Yeah, I want to meet her.
So exciting. It's like suddenly turned into blind date.
Yeah. Wow.
Do you like a Louis?
What's your name?
Carol.
Well, say hi, Carol. Say hello to Louis. Give her a kiss, Louis.
How you doing? Good to see you.
That's cheered him up. So we've just been hearing that you've got a bit of a crush on Louis.
Definitely.
And you four are going to go on a double date.
Yes!
Really?
Yeah.
Apparently so.
Yeah.
Are you okay with watching your daughter do the audition?
No, she can't watch me do audition.
So you're going to do something you think your mum may not like?
I'll get grounded. You go out, Mum.
And then, don't worry, because I'll give you Louis' number, we'll work everything out.
Say bye to Louis, Mum.
Bye. Nice to meet you.
Louis, do you like her? Tell me
the
truth.
Look at his face.
She don't want a broken heart now.
I wouldn't do that.
Okay, right, your mum's not there. What are you going to sing, Rochelle?
Oh, God. Just a Little by Liberty X. Sexy. Everything about you so sexy. You don't even know what you've... Yeah, you're really hitting my spot. Oh yeah, yeah. Work it a little bit, hot it a little bit. Me in the middle of it, go just a little bit more. Give me just a little bit more, just a little, just a little. I can sing it better than that, guys. Honestly, I was just so nervous.
I don't think that's necessary.
Yeah.
Did you like
can
it?
I look
no, but I can sing better than that. Honestly.
This is not being rude. I would watch that over and over again with the volume off.
Oh,
I'd love it. We're going to vote on this. Louis, yes or no?
Please, Louis.
I don't think singing is for you.
Singing
I don't think that singing is going to be your career.
Cheryl.
I think for once in my life, I agree with Louis.
Danny.
Burlesque, yes. Singing, no.
You know, the good news is, Rochelle, I think you're going to get a lot of job offers off the back of this audition. Won't have much to do with singing, but it was, it's a no for me as well.
All right, thank you. Nice to meet you.
She is going to be in so much trouble when her mum watches that.
Let's just dress a double date.
He said yes to take you out for a date.
Right. So do we need to make him stick to this?
Yeah, we do. He can take me to McDonald's if you like. Kentucky.
Right, let's see if those boys are up for a bit of fast food action.
I come bearing gifts. One for you, Simon, and one for you, Louis. Guess what these are?
Rochelle and the mother.
Got it in one.
Are you serious?
I am deadly serious. They want their double date.
Rochelle's mum, Carol, said she'd be quite happy with McDonald's.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Nice long dinner.
So as Simon awaits a call back from Rochelle, and Louis texts her mum.
Hello, it's Louis.
Let's move on to the final instalment of the indispensable, ridiculously useful, it's almost like cheating, judges do's and don'ts.
Don't do that, don't do that, don't do that. Don't do that, don't do that, don't do that.
Okay, do wear deodorant.
Well, the guys will the motors start from the guy who knows. I love my love and I love still grows.
Try and be relaxed.
What happens afterwards? Don't worry.
And if you're not, take a deep breath.
Yeah.
Tell us something about you that we go, oh.
I've been slimming and I've lost 18 and a half stone in weight.
18 and a half stone you've lost?
Stone, yeah.
Wow.
I used to be 29 and a half stone.
Because then as a judge, you feel like you know the person. Oh, I want that person in my category.
Yeah. That is not you.
I can't believe it's the same person.
Wow.
Don't. I was going to say don't shout at us, but sometimes it's funny when people have a go at us.
She's 35, so what? Just because she doesn't look perfect like any of you, do you know how much that meant to us?
Hey! Oh, Louis, still nothing from Rochelle's mum. Never mind. Next up to see the judges and feeling like he's walking on broken glass is 16-year-old student Alex Campbell. Alex,
yeah.
Who is your all-time biggest, greatest idol?
Annie Lennox.
Why? Is she your greatest idol?
I love her.
You love her?
I like songs as well.
Why? Do you want to be the X Factor winner?
I want to prove people wrong.
Why?
Some people don't believe in me.
What song are you singing?
Little Bird.
Annie Lennox?
Yeah.
Why?
It's my favourite one.
Hi.
Hello. What's your name?
Alex.
Alex, what age are you?
16.
And Alex, is there any person in music business that inspires you?
Annie Lennox.
And Alex, what are you going to sing today?
Annie Lennox song, Little Bird.
Look up to...
No, it's a stupid song, that.
Oh, OK.
What's your second song?
It was Fawn and Blondes.
Great.
Into a greasing dust where I'm lying in bed just to get it out. What's in my head and I am feeling a little bit cool, yeah. And when I wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep breath and I get real high and I scream to the top of my lungs, what's going on?
OK.
Oh.
How do you think you did?
Oh, not too well by your face.
It was all over the place, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was like sending out Star Trek.
Sorry.
You know what I mean?
Do you know what he means?
No.
I've never watched it.
All right, well, watch it, you'll understand. Louis, yes or no?
No.
Cheryl?
No.
Danny?
No.
Sorry.
Why? Do you think it was Four Nose?
Because he didn't benefit when I mentioned what song I was going to be singing for the first one. he just said no, doesn't like it. So then I got to see my second one, I wasn't prepared for it at all, so I was shaking.
You're not going to give up totally, though, are you?
I don't know.
No.
I'm not coming back at you, though.
Why? Are you not going to come back?
Because it's been a journey.
No reply from Rochelle's mum, Louis.
Hello, it's Louis again.
Still to come.
Atrocious. Boring, terrible. Completely insane. Terrible. I hate it.
No star quality at all here.
How do you feel?
Delighted.
Hello, hang on a minute. All right, I've just left you for like 2 seconds and you're wandering around, getting yourself into trouble. I'm going to have to put you back on those baby reins, slap on a bib and watch you drool all over this Extra Factor action.
The next contestant to walk up to the desk and collect a sticky number is diehard Madonna fan Rita from Newport.
My name's Rita Brigitte Zaffirio and I'm a hospital cleaner. I love Madonna, I love the dance moves and everything about her, the clothes she wore. So if things had gone different for me, I think I could have been as big as Madonna.
Step. Right, what's your name?
I'm Rita Brigitte Zaffirio.
And where are you from?
I live in Newport.
Okay, how old are you, sweetheart?
39.
Which artist do you think you could be more successful than next year?
Like Madonna.
Madonna. Mm. I had a feeling you were going to say that.
You have a resemblance, Simon.
Yeah.
You look a bit like her with the hair.
Thanks.
And all that.
All right, off you go.
Right. Come on, Vogue, let your body move to the music. Hey, 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 come on, Vogue, let your body go with the flow. You know you can do it, come on, Vogue. Ooh, you gotta move to the music. Ooh, come on, Vogue. Let your body go with the flow. You know you can
do it. Got it. Rita, I thought the whole thing was just completely insane, if I'm being honest with you. I just didn't understand all the weird hand things you were doing.
No.
Louis, did you like it?
I thought she did a good impersonation of Madonna.
You think that sounded like Madonna?
I think she looks like Madonna.
You think it sounded like Madonna?
No.
Then it's not a good impersonation. Cheryl, do you like her?
Yeah, it was a bit like you were raving. No, I didn't get it, if I'm honest.
But, Rita, you entertained us, so thank you very much.
You could have caused a pile-up outside with all those hand signals.
Let your body go with the flow.
Louis, yes or no? Why are you even hesitating?
Because I'm thinking. I'm going to say no.
Yeah.
Cheryl?
No.
Danny?
No, but thank you.
Rita Brigitte, it's a no, but nice to meet you, darling.
Thank you very much.
It was more like Big Fish, Little Fish, Cardboard Box than Vogue.
Yeah.
Can you teach me to Vogue?
Yeah. Come on, Vogue, let your body move to the music. Come on, Vogue, let
your body move.
Oh, this is a bit ravey.
I think I need a bit more practice, don't I?
Yeah.
Yeah, just a little bit. I'll leave it to you, the expert.
Hi, Danny. What are you looking at?
Nothing.
So just busted you, didn't
you?
I knew you were into that kind of thing. Listen, Danny, if you want to see it, you only just have to ask. Do you want to see it? Okay, here it is.
Hello, viewers. Welcome back to another of Louis' Limericks. There was a young man named O'Leary, and we love him because he's ever so cheery. So at the end of the shows, when he packs up and goes, he leaves all the contestants teary.
Sometimes on The Extra Factor, there can be so much talent, it can seem a bit like you're seeing doubled. Know what I mean?
Hello, boys.
Hello.
Hi, how's it going?
Very good, thank you.
Now, either you are incredibly similar looking or you are twins.
We are indeed.
Or both.
Yeah, or both, that's fine.
Yeah. So, singing together, a twin boy band.
Yeah.
There's been twin groups in the past. I'm obviously thinking of the Cheeky Girls here.
Well, we're not. Well, hopefully, we're not going to be seen as the Cheeky Boys. No,
we're not going down the cheeky route.
So no little gold hot pants or anything like that. Are you good?
Of course we're good.
Yeah. Out of 10?
What? 9.9? So, not, yeah.
So good?
Yeah, so good.
So we're in for a treat. Hi.
We're at Symmetry. I'm Tom.
I'm Jack.
How old are you guys?
22 last Friday.
Twins?
Yeah.
Are your parents in farming?
No. No.
Because they look like farmer's sons.
But nothing wrong with that.
There's not anything wrong. I'm just asking the question.
Okay, what's the song? Your song.
Good.
I sat on the roof and I kicked off the moss. What a few of the verses were they? They got me quite cross. But the sun's been kind while I wrote this song. Well, it's for people like you then. Keep it turned on. So excuse me for getting open these things I do. You see, I've forgotten if they're green or they're blue. Anyway, the thing is, what I really mean, yours are the sweetest eyes I've ever seen.
Thanks, guys. You sound like Stephen Gately.
Really?
Is that good or bad?
Terrible.
Not good.
Guys, it was utterly atrocious, the whole thing. I mean, seriously awful. I mean, you were bad, and then your brother kicked in, who was even worse.
Yeah. And guys, there's no star quality at all here.
Nothing.
It was boring, actually.
How do you feel?
I'm delighted.
Bit good, but then I'd rather have honest opinions than you try to give.
Exactly.
Okay.
Good exactly.
Movie. Let's take a vote. Lulu?
No.
Cheryl?
No, but I like your attitude.
Simon?
No.
Well, that's 4 no's. Sorry, guys.
Thank you.
See you.
Bye.
We can make it if we try.
Were you shocked by what the judges said?
Not exactly. We were all over the place.
Danny said you sounded like Stephen Gately. Is that a good thing?
I'd no idea. Well, Ballzone were big, weren't they? So I can't see
anything. So it must be a good thing, surely?
Yeah.
Well, listen, I wish you both all the luck, and hopefully we'll meet you again at some point. We definitely enjoyed that chat, didn't we?
Yeah, it was lovely to meet you both.
We'll see you again.
Brilliant.
Simon.
Yes?
Sorry, I'm going to annoy you. I'm only going to be quick, though, because I'm desperate for the loo. It's been so exciting, I haven't been able to go all day. How was Cardiff?
Terrible.
Oh, no.
No, it was.
Why?
He loved it, I hated it.
I loved it.
You've had the best day ever, because you've just been hanging out, making friends.
People are incredible.
You should have a lot of checks outside. Why are you standing like this, Holly? You're kind of like...
Because I need the loo.
Well, go to the loo.
I've got to ask you
questions. No, because this is uncomfortable talking to you when I know you want to go to the loo. Oh.
Can you ask him about Mark Darkside and about Kerry?
Yes.
Ask him that,
yes.
And I'll be back, and I'll see you tomorrow.
Good.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Oh. See you there, Rob.
Quick, I need that. Well, that's it for Cardiff, but that's definitely not it for our auditions. Join us next week to see more people beg the judges for that place at boot camp. See you next time.
The end of the audition.
Maybe get a banana on a boat out.
Weird. I've got a candle. What have you got?
Is it love you're after or just a good time?
Does anyone else get a candle?
Oh, no. Mm-hmm.
Anyone else get a candle?
No.
It's just me.
This has got to stop.
Watch backstage interviews and relive the auditions at itv.com/X Factor. Next tonight, crudely impersonating the rich and famous, it's Katie Brand's Big Ass Show.